So I'm here in the Water Cube in Stockholm World Water Week with Brecht Momme from SMV. Brecht, go ahead, introduce yourself.
Okay, so my name is Brecht Momme. I work with SNV, Netherlands Development Organization, and I'm based in Uganda, in the northwest of Uganda.
Yeah.
I work there with SNV, and we provide capacity building services to local organizations at the sub-national level, at district level.
Yeah.
So we do that to district local governments, we give that advice to NGOs, private sector, and our aim is to really make a difference at the grassroots level, so
yeah.
People having access to water, sanitation and hygiene. We don't go to the communities ourselves, but we give the advice to these organizations so they can improve their service delivery and so reach out to more people, have more sustainable services at that level.
Okay. And so now you're in Stockholm. Is this your first time or have you been here before?
It's my first time
in
Stockholm.
It's your first time? Wow. So
yeah.
How's it treating you?
It's very good. I'm very happy to be in Stockholm.
Yeah.
I'm coming here on an invitation. I'm here to present in the side event Striking Communications on the topic of knowledge and information sharing. My case is about district-based learning, whereby we bring all the organizations at the district level together and we engage them in a process of dialogue, of sharing information, building trust and learning from each other.
Yeah.
And it's very fascinating what comes out of such a process.
Okay. And this is tomorrow, you said earlier?
It's at 5:15 on Wednesday.
Okay.
Striking Marsh Communications.
Okay. So, just more of a broad question. You now have the chance to address the world.
Okay.
What's your, in your vision, the issue concerning water or your message to the world on this?
Okay. Well, let me relate to this case is really about, you have to understand first before you can be understood. When we bring all these people together and the complete miscommunication there is between them and also the miscommunication there is between the people working in the sector and the people they want to address, it is very, very striking. So that is maybe my message when it comes to water and sanitation. Try to first understand the people on the ground, what are their issues, what are their problems, what are their challenges, what are the obstacles, what prevents them from accessing these services is very, very vital before you start to communicate and start to address what you want to address.
And a lot of time, a lot more complicated than it seems.
Yes.
It's not just you don't have water, but there's a lot more things going on.
Yeah, and for example, what we encountered in the case is that the practitioners in WASH, they said people are stubborn, they don't understand this, they are unrealistic, they're lazy, and their idea was we need to have a bylaw.
Yeah.
And when we had a look at like at the community level and we went to their places, we realized that there is no such thing as stubborn communities.
Yeah.
People have very good reasons why they don't have a latrine or why they don't change. And unless you understand what those reasons are, you will not be able to transform anything with your messages. So you really need to understand what is the problem, and based on that you can design your intervention or your communication based on what is really there on the ground.
Okay, well, hope you have a good week.
I hope so. I already have a great week.
Thanks so much.
Very nice.
Thanks so much for this interview.
Okay.